Well, good morning. It's great to see everyone this morning, and welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time, and everyone is welcome, safe, and loved. This month's topic is power, and our speaker today is Helen Wright, our spiritual leader, and the topic will be Finding the Power of the Mother Within. But before we do that, let's have Tanya offer us our spiritual reading.
Good morning. Good morning from Tucson. This is a quote from Maya Angelou's book, Mom and Me and Mom. And then she says, love heals and liberates. I use the word love, not meaning sentimentality, but a condition so strong that it may be that which holds the stars in their heavenly positions, and that which causes the blood to flow orderly in our veins. Thank you, Maya Angelou. Thank you.
Thank you, Tanya. I am Kay Brilliant, and I am the prayer chaplain at Unity of Las Cruces. And let me see. I have already gotten off the course. So let me try this again. Helen Wright will be our speaker, and the topic will be Finding the Power of the Mother Within. Helen will also provide us meditation following the message. Today's musicians are Max Contreras and Barry Shaw, and the music will be A Mother's Love. How appropriate for a happy Mother's Day. And now, Ken, how about some good news?
I think we can work on something like that. All right. Good morning, everybody. I want to share this little tidbit. This is a news article you may have seen on your perusal through the news services. I'm just going to read what it says on the right-hand side of the screen. This is in regards to a lady. Her name is Lavinia. They call her Lavi Mwanga, and she boarded a recent flight to Hawaii for a family vacation. But she had no idea she'd be coming off the plane with a brand new son. Mwanga didn't know she was pregnant, but about halfway through the flight, in her own words, her baby boy just came out of nowhere. Luckily, there was a doctor and not one, but three neonatal intensive care unit nurses aboard this flight who got really creative with their emergency medical care. Dr. Dale Glenn, along with nurses Lonnie Bamfield, Amanda Beating, and Mimi Ho, used shoelaces to tie the umbilical cord and made baby warmers out of microwave bottles. At one point, in absence of more traditional tools, they used an Apple Watch to monitor the baby's heart rate. Once the plane landed, Mwanga and her new son, Raymond, were transported to a local hospital, and everyone walked away safe and happy, and with quite a story to tell. So you never know what's going to happen on those flights, everybody. Just pay attention to what's going on around you. All right, back to you guys.
Oh, thank you, Ken. What a big surprise when you're on your way to a vacation. Please join me as we have our moment of gratitude. We, all of us who are Unity of Las Cruces, are grateful for everyone who enlivens our church and lifts the vibration. And mostly we need to remember the people behind the scenes who attend and who watch on YouTube, in addition to the Unity of Las Cruces Board of Trustees, our social media outreach, helpers and donors and tithers, those who offer anonymous prayers, musicians, our speakers, including today's, thanks Helen, Zoom and YouTube and email producer, all of the technology. Where would we be without Zoom? Thank you for raising the vibrations of this universe through your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations, and for allowing the love and light and healing to flow through you to others and to the entire planet. Helen, will you bring us an opening prayer?
So, I open the prayer being grateful for technology and invite us all to just settle in, relax, release, let go, and let God. And as we breathe in, we go deeper into our personal sanctuary, our center. And from that place, we are connected with our Mother, Father, God's love. And especially today, focusing on the Mother God, that divine transfiguring love within us. We connect with that power of love, that power of a mother's love in all of us. And from that place, a place of gratitude, a place of appreciation, a place of creation, of life, of affirming life, we affirm that love and that life in every one of us. And we affirm our gratitude for the creation and being able to be alive in physical form and here right now, where we can contribute to the vibration and the energy of this earth, our Mother Earth. We give thanks for all of the gifts that come from a mother's love, of compassion, of empathy, of nurturing. And as we settle in further, we recognize that divine mother love in everyone, in all of us, in each one of us, in its many, many expressions and manifestations. And for all of this, we are grateful, give thanks, and say thank you, God. And so it is.
Amen.
And so now I'd like to welcome Dave Ady with our daily word.
Thank you, Reverend Helen, and happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. Today's affirmation for Mother's Day, May 9th, 2021, I give thanks for motherly love. God's perfect love, expressing through my mother, gave me life. God's love, wisdom, and strength guided her and all those who nurtured me as I grew. My words of praise and gratitude let me show my mother how much I appreciate her. When I wish to demonstrate my appreciation for my mother's example, I share the nurturing, motherly love of God in my words and actions with all people. Remembering the times when my mother or another compassionate person listened patiently and shared encouraging words, I seek to be a caring, supportive presence. Recalling my mother's joy each time I learned something new, I share my skills and knowledge willingly when someone seeks my help. In gratitude, I share the gift of nurturing love. From Scripture, Isaiah 66, verse 13, as a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. And together, please, our affirmation. I give thanks for motherly love. And so it is. Amen.
I was just going to introduce Jane Ray for our affirmation for unity.
The affirmation for unity. Guided by infinite love,
and wisdom,
and with God as our source, we now behold unlimited possibilities as unity of Las Cruces grows and prospers.
Thank you, Jane. So now it's time for our message. So as you heard, the title of my talk is Finding the Power of the Mother Within. And what came to mind was since I was actually speaking for the Center for Spiritual Living as well this Sunday, there were the themes of the month, and the Center for Spiritual Living theme was holy, holy, rising and uprising. And this really led me to think about the uprising, or the rising up of the energy of the divine feminine, the coming back into holy wholeness, of the divine feminine and the divine masculine, perfectly together in balance. And as Kay mentioned, our unity theme is power, and focusing on spiritual power this month. So where is the power? The power is within each of us. I was also thinking about mothers, and particularly this last year, it's been a tough year for many, many mothers around the world, but particularly we know in this country where many mothers have had to stay home and homeschool and were no longer able to continue with their jobs and their roles in community. So for many reasons, it's been a challenging year for many. And then I playfully played with a title of Mothers in Revolt or Mothers in Revolution, because again, it's this energy of the divine feminine coming back into more obvious expression in the physical world. But first, let's begin in the Garden of Eden. So I want to begin with Eve and the serpent, because they've been the cause of much abuse against women and the powers of patriarchy. I think many of this can come back to a literal interpretation of the Garden of Eden and the role of Eve. And it came home to me when I was watching a British murder mystery, I think, because I like the British murder mysteries. And they put the role, they called one of the main characters in this particular show was Eve, because she was a temptress and because she was leading people in a different direction. And I thought, gosh, this is really ingrained in us. So I'd like to help us all see Eve in a different light. The Metaphysical Bible Dictionary says Eve is elementary life, life and living. And there's a passage in Genesis 3:20 that says the first woman, and this is in the Bible, not on the planet Earth, the first woman, and man called his wife's name Eve because she was the mother of all living. This mother of all living. Further metaphysical studies is Eve is love or feeling in individual consciousness. The I am wisdom puts feeling into what it thinks. And so Eve, feeling, becomes the mother of all living. Feeling, this is the continuing on from the metaphysical interpretation, feeling is spirit, which quickens. Woman symbolizes the soul region of man and is the mother principle of God in expression. And I must say that the first time I went into a Unity church and they opened the prayer with Mother, Father, God, I nearly fell off my chair in celebration and hallelujah and seeing the mother aspect of the divine. So I'll come back to this mother aspect of Mother God a little later, but first let's return to the story of the Garden of Eden and Adam and Eve and the serpent and explore that in a little bit more detail. There is a metaphysical interpretation by Reverend Ed Rabel, and he taught for many years at Unity Village. He taught a lot of the metaphysics, and I really love his metaphysical interpretations of many of the well-known Bible stories. So the Garden of Eden stands for the purely, totally interior realm of being. And he compares that to a baby, a human baby in the uterus, in a prenatal state. So Eve in Eden symbolizes the potential or the ability to feel. It's a symbol of this ability to feel. Adam in Eden is the potential, again, the same, the divine ideas in the mind of God, but the symbol of the ability to think. So while Eve and Adam are in this, in Eden, in this prenatal type state, they're not capable of knowing good and evil. They're not capable of knowing that they may be doing something that's labeled as a wrong action because they're only in this potential state. So Eve in the garden is the potential for the ability to feel, whereas Eve out of Eden is the symbol of feeling. Adam in Eden is the potential or the symbol of the ability to think. And Adam out of Eden is the ability to think. And then we have the wonderful serpent. I like snakes. Not too close, but I do have an appreciation for snakes. So reclaiming the snake, serpent. Serpent means sense consciousness or the desire to experience sensation. Sensation is the ability to experience life with the senses. And Ed Reibel goes on to say that the five senses are spiritual. They're spiritual in origin. Their purpose is spiritual. And their purpose is to serve spirit. So senses are good, are of spirit. And then humans can choose with their free will to do other things. If we allow the senses to become the masters, and then we and our ego aspect become the servant to senses, that's known as sense consciousness. And it's a dangerous place to be, because if we're relying entirely on our senses and not in balance with our thoughts and with our true essence, which is in the image of God, if we're relying on our senses too much, it can lead to addictions. So it's an interesting aspect of the senses being good. However, we need to be in the position of our spiritual power, our power of being aligned with the divine, and so as we're not taken over by the senses. So now in this story, the ability to feel in potential leads to the knowledge and moving out of the Eden state to feel and experience life. And are we not spiritual beings having a physical experience? So the Eden state, the interior, is a place where we're unable to know this duality, and we're not capable of doing wrong in this Eden state. So if we were to put the whole of the characters in the story of the Garden of Eden on trial, I would have to say that Eve is not guilty. She was incapable of knowingly doing wrong. Adam, not guilty. Serpent, not guilty. And the serpent, God spoke to the serpent, and the serpent was created by God. So again, it makes sense that God is good, always, everywhere present. So it changes our perception of some of the what's actually going on in the Garden of Eden and the story of it metaphysically. And Reibel said that it's better to say Eve is female rather than saying woman, because we're looking at a feminine quality. And then Adam, we're looking at a male energy or quality. So leaving Eden was the only way to die to the prenatal state and to move out to experience life. You might even say that that is divine order. And I wanted to read to you directly from Ed Reibel, because he then makes a parallel as to what goes on in our lives. He says, if an individual has not taken this step, then he would lack all that goes to make up what we call having experiences or experiencing life. The lack of knowledge of good or evil will remove all necessity for you to make decisions. You would feel no need to learn anything, and there would be no incentive for you to make changes. You would not have any problems, because you would have no way of knowing what problems are. You would not get sick, because you would not even have the ability to know and be aware of the body. What it all boils down to would be you wouldn't want to resemble a vegetable or a mineral. But the E factor of us has already caused it not to be this way. Our feeling nature has already responded to the initial desire to have an experience of life and not to remain passively innocent towards it. And we have entered life, become involved with it, partaken of its adventure through the senses. And so we have died to Eden, but not to life. I often think of a newborn baby. The baby really, in a sense, has died to the prenatal state of existence, which for the baby was Eden. The little baby has everything provided for her except knowledge, knowledge of her own existence. He writes, her, how do I know it's a her? Everything mentioned that is of truth in the Bible is true on corresponding levels. We have it reenacted in our biology. The baby being born, dying to its prenatal state and being born to life. Or Adam and Eve in us, dying to that complete passive, ignorant level of you, into a knowledge acquiring and life experiencing level of existence. So having reclaimed some new insights from the Garden of Eden, I'd like to now share some of the thoughts of Patricia Cota Robles. And she's a consciousness evolutionary. She talks about the mother god or the divine feminine. She has a term falling from grace, but not again in the traditional sense. She describes this as coming into experience denser energies. And as we did that, we closed our heart chakras so we wouldn't feel the pain of what we were creating through our misuse of free will and our creative faculties of thought and feeling. This closing our heart chakras so as we wouldn't see or feel the effects of miscreations, she said, is a blocked flow of our mother god's divine love. And she said it catapulted it into a distorted patriarchal consciousness, fear-based, and also error thinking, because she points out that we came to believe, the sons and daughters of God came to believe that they were the children of a masculine father God and only had one parent. And she comments, how could that be? We know that we are conceived through the energies of the feminine and the masculine. And so in the traditional model, we know it as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Patricia Cota Robles says that this is really Father God's, who is the divine will and power. And the Mother God is the transfiguring divine love, the nurturer, the comforter. And we had blocked that flow from the Mother God. And more in recent times, we are now opening our heart chakras. We are opening to welcome in the divine mother, the mother god. And so we're now recognizing that we do have indeed two aspects of God as our creator coming together. And we are then the creation of the sons and daughters of both of these aspects of God. So we are reclaiming this divine feminine known as Holy Spirit or Holy Ghost as feminine aspect of God. And through this, this is the way that we know that we're connected with all life. We're becoming whole and holy and bringing the divine feminine and divine masculine into balance. So when I think about finding the power of the mother within, the divine feminine as Holy Spirit, nurturer, comforter, transfiguring divine love, Mother God. That is in each and every one of us. It's not just in females, women. That is part, the divine is within. Therefore, both aspects of deity are within each of us. With everyone as we open our hearts more and more. So let me share a story. The story is about a woman named Eileen, and she had the power of the mother within. She gave birth to her first child, a baby boy, whose name was Philip. And it came to be obvious that he was born with some problems, maybe spina bifida, and certainly a hole in the heart. And back in the 1950s, technology developments had not evolved to the state where they can now fix the hole in the heart, but there they could not heal the hole in the heart. And so the hospital staff, and this was the paradigm at the time, expected that they would keep Philip at the hospital and he would die. And Eileen I call this the uprising, this revolution of the and knowing this feminine power of the mother God within, said, no, we're going to take him home. We're going to give him all the love, all the cherishing. And I come to appreciate how much courage that took, because this is my mother. And although I haven't always had an easy relationship with my mother, I now look back and go, wow, I admire her courage. I admire her ability with that mother's intuition, knowing her baby needed a mother's love, to know that there would be heartbreak and yet still go and do it anyway. That's the power with the heart broken open to actually feel and love. And especially, as I say, knowing what the prognosis was with Philip was, she still brought him home to love, to cherish, and to then hold him in his arms as he made his transition. Eileen also had far more courage than I knew. She was advised not to have children at all because she'd had rheumatic fever. And having had her first child, and she still went on to have three more pregnancies for my brother, two brothers, and myself. And I've come to think about this, of what's the point of having feeling if we can't really feel all of our experiences here on this planet in the physical. So this ability to open our heart with the mother's love, this unconditional love, that can be fierce, it can be courageous, it can be gentle. And there are many, many other stories of a mother's love. But I would just invite you to just take a moment, just a really brief moment, to connect with the aspect of your own physical mother's love here in the physical realm, just to remember that love and maybe even see it in a new light. As I say, many of us may not have had a so-called idyllic relationship with our mothers, may not have had that close bond, but there's so many aspects of that divine feminine love, the mother God love in all of us, that just invite you to see how was that expressed? Was it unconditional love? Were there moments of that? Was it courageous love? Was it nurturing or comforting? Or was it artistic and thinking outside of the box, different aspects of love and power and intuition and instinct and caring? So let's just take a moment and connect and appreciate our own mother's love. And as we go throughout the day, we may have more and more insights and be able to have a revelation or new insights into our mother's love. And I admire and respect my mother for following a mother's deep intuition regarding the needs of her child. I read recently that a mother's intuition is one of the most powerful forces in the world. So there's many, many examples of this divine mother's love in all humans, men, women, children. Stories of incredible strength, as someone, a mother might lift a car off her to save a child. Incredible strength in that moment. Or I even could reframe some of the firemen who go into burning buildings. That's expressing that same unconditional love. It might be a job, might be perceived as many, many things, but it's also that courage of love and respecting all life. But I also see incredible acts of love in the animal kingdom. I've seen many stories of cats mother cats going into a burning building to retrieve every single one of her kittens. I recently read about a male cat who adopted and nurtured a motherless kittens and raised them, and demonstrating this quality. And then I also look at the aspect of a mother's love over the long haul, over the lifetime, because once a mother, always a mother. And yet many of us are mothers to our creations. It might be an artistic creation. It might be writing a book. It might be creating a beautiful garden. So our creations and our children may take many forms other than the traditional human form. So humans, all of us, can tap in and express this divine love. And again, I invite you to ponder on different other words for this power of the divine feminine expressed in, through, and as us when we open our hearts to feeling. So today we are celebrating all mothers, mothers in female form, but that divine in all, that unconditional, nurturing, comforting. We reclaim Eve as the mother of all living. And as Patricia Cota Robles says, it's the mother God's divine love, which was is intended to perpetuate within us the knowing that we are one with life. So that opening our heart, that divine mother, that's what helps connect us with what we in unity know to be true, that we are all one, we are all connected, that oneness concept. And as we allow more and more of the divine mother, the mother God, to be expressed through us, again, we heal the rifts that have been caused partly by patriarchy. We heal ourselves by bringing both of those aspects into balance. And from an Ojibwe teacher I know, blessings and balance, for with balance comes all blessings. So as we come into balance, we are blessed. And so it is. So I would like to invite us to prepare for meditation. And if we could have that meditation slide for those of you who may want to keep your eyes open and just feel that caring, nurturing love. And so I just invite everyone to close your eyes if you feel comfortable doing so, or keep them open with a gentle gaze, and go within and following the breath within. And first we connect again, as we did earlier, with that moment of looking towards the experience of our mother's, our own mother's love. But looking specifically through the eyes of the divine mother with compassion and empathy, and finding those moments, those events, something where we know that mother God was being expressed. It may be in the daily, everyday experiences as we were a child. It may be a mother pointing out a flower or teaching us how to care for a pet. Just allowing our thoughts, our feelings, our memories, our awareness and our presence to just stand in that place with our mother. Reclaiming and seeing that in the best light that we can in this moment. And that divine quality of Mother God opens our hearts to empathy and compassion, opens our hearts to nurturing and caring, caring about our Mother Earth, caring about creation, all of creation, and caring about our own creations. As we celebrate the coming back into power, that power within of the Mother God expressed in all of us. We allow ourselves to nurture and grow that compassionate power. So it's even more available to all of life. And as we let these thoughts and feelings just be, whatever comes up, just let's invite those thoughts, feelings, memories to be present. As we take a moment deep within, in the place of the Most High, our personal sanctuary, as we move into the silence, is taking that mother's love in all of its expressions for the moment in the silence. And as we gently bring ourselves back to this present moment and become aware of our surroundings and aware of our heart chakra, open with that amazing, awesome, beautiful, powerful Goddess, Mother God, Divine Feminine, that mother quality of compassion, creation, and caring. As we open our eyes and maybe wiggle around, stretch our fingers, our toes, and become fully present, we are so grateful for this day, this place, and Mother God. So it is. Thank you.
Pride, you've always held out a loving hand. formed me like only a mama can. No ocean floor lies deeper, no perfume is sweeter, and no gift is given freer than a mother's love. Sometimes I drive you crazy. Sometimes you drive me there too. But the tides are strong, so it don't take long till the love comes pouring through. No ocean floor lies deep.
Please join me in prayer as we affirm our prayer of faith. God is my help in every need. God does my every hunger feed. God dwells within me, guides my way through every moment, night and day. I now am wise, I now am true, patient, kind, and loving too. All things I am, can do and be through Christ, the truth that is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. Amen.
Our tithe recipient this week is the Center for Spiritual Living in the heart of Las Cruces, which is our physical spiritual sanctuary and home here in Las Cruces. And we certainly envision being back there at some point this year, where we can all again be physically together in spiritual community. And for now, let's just hold the energy of our tithes going to the CSL in our hands, in our hearts, connected to our hearts, going out to CSL, out to the world, and that whole law of circulation, that love, that energy comes back to us so as we can continue to move that love and energy into the world. So it is. Thank you.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Your love blessings can be made at the Unity of Las Cruces website or on the weekly email. You can mail your gift, donation, or tithe to the P.O. Box. Your gift is given in love, goes out to the others in love, and love returns tenfold. And so it is.
And thank you, everyone, for your tithes, by whatever means they come in. Thank you for your ongoing support. Next Sunday, we have the Power of Power. And our speaker will be Sandy Anderson, a licensed Unity teacher. And so she will be joining us, and I'm so looking forward to hear her thoughts on the Power of Power. And this is the May schedule of speakers. So Sandy Anderson, I will be back on the 23rd to speak. And then Reverend Pat Conway will be speaking on May 30th. You're welcome to join us for the www, the Welcome the Word on Wednesdays. So please join us at 9:30. Look forward to seeing everyone, anyone who wants to join that's new, you're most welcome. And just the ongoing donations that are so much valued are we're still collecting. And just check ahead that the CSL is open. Usually Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays are good days to just check in and then bring in donations. Thank you all for joining this Sunday virtual service celebration for Mother's Day. And you're welcome to stay after the service so as we can check in and talk to each other. Going out into this week, continue to connect and express that nurturing love in all and every situation that we can, so as that love continues to flow out into the world. And so now we have our prayer for protection, followed by the peace song.
Please join us as we affirm the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Amen.
Again, thank you all for joining this service today, and have a blessed week. Namaste. Thank you.
Thanks, Helen.
Thanks, Helen. Thank you. That was excellent. Beautiful. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for a wonderful thank message. You. Amen.
Yeah, thank you, Helen, for the service.